Like that. Hello? Always press the button. That makes it work. Hello, you are right. It is always difficult to follow that song. And you know what's even more difficult is to follow Melanie Popejoy in anything that she or any of her choirs ever do. So it is wonderful that we were being able to open today with voices and with song, because those voices and song always make, I think music always makes us feel better. No matter where we are, it might be raining outside, but we had some beautiful music to make everyone, to lighten our day, and to begin this wonderful appreciation ceremony for all of the gifts that we have in the room. So first and foremost, today is our celebration of gifts. The gifts that we have in the room start with our students. Our students have tremendous time and energy to devote to their talents and their skills, and we want to help develop and reward this energy that they give with their time and their talents. And it is a gift that you give to everyone in the fields that you're studying. We also have donors and alumni who were like you, students at one time, and they chose to take time and develop their own gifts and their own talents, and they also decided that they would spend some time giving back to us and to you, and sharing those gifts of time and talent and also treasure by supporting our scholarships in our scholarship students here, as well as our scholarship students online. So thank you first and foremost to the students for their hard work here and online that are visiting us today, as well as our alumni and our donors here today, as well as visiting us online, for everything that you're doing to support our college. And of course, we have other gifts in the room, our faculty and our staff in our college that work hard every day to support our students in sharing their gifts as widely as we can. So I wanted to welcome everyone today, and we have two speakers that will be coming up before our panel, Dr. Jenny Bladow, Dr. Jesse Rhodes, and again, I will start by just saying welcome, and also again, another thank you for your time today, and I will bring Dr. Bladow next to the stage.
Hi, everyone. I have to make myself not a transcript, but I tend to go off tangent on things. And so I'm going to follow my script so that I don't go too far off with you today. But as you may have heard, we're experiencing a teacher shortage right now, right? Pretty critical, not only in North Dakota, but nationwide. And so here at UND, we're really invested in combating that teacher shortage in many different ways. So while I know that's not our topic of conversation today, I wanted to open the door to invite conversation. If you catch me after this event or send me an email, give me a call. I'm happy to share what we are doing, but also to get your ideas of what we could be doing to get more teachers into the field, and also to have those quality teachers that are already out there stay and continue to make an impact on students. So again, I'll save that for another day, but you might ask yourself, why is it so important to have donors providing scholarships for students who are pursuing a teaching degree? And as I mentioned, we have a current teacher shortage. We just don't have as many people coming into the field as we did before. And again, we're working on that. But the idea of having scholarships definitely helps students complete the teaching degree with less financial stress, which I think we can all argue is pretty amazing. So I believe some of you have even chosen to specifically provide scholarships for students who are engaged in their semester of student teaching. And if you didn't know, that's by far the most expensive semester for students. So it's important to get that scholarship funding for students at any point in their career, but even more critical during student teaching. So again, in case you didn't know, they're paying regular tuition, but they're also paying student teaching fees on top of that to pay for their cooperating teacher, that classroom teacher that's hosting them, and then also their UND supervisor who goes out and is kind of their mentor throughout the experience. And we also tell them we don't recommend that they have a job on top of that, because it's a lot. They're already full-time student teaching, which is a big, it's a lot for them to manage on top of anything else. So Let's see. I could go on and on talking about teacher ed, obviously. But again, I think it's just important for people to realize just the funding and what it looks like when it comes to the teacher ed program and specifically student teaching. So my final thought I want to leave you with is that several of our current students may not have been able to be here today or online or in our program. Not only teachers, but educational leaders without your support. So I just want to thank you to our donors for the final financial assistance that you have provided our students today and moving forward. So thank you. Dr. Rhodes is next. It's already on.
Okay, so I brought chem sheet too. So I've been asked to give a few. Successes that we've had in kinesiology over the past few years, and these successes are in large part due to scholarship students coming into our program, amplifying the students that are already there, bringing in success to those programs. So in kinesiology, we've actually had a 36% increase in student population over the past 4 years. And we're actually currently ranked number third as far as online kinesiology programs. So we've had quite a bit of success there. We've also expanded out into esports. It's actually a thing. And we have actually expanded that out into one of our majors. And we have established a pretty good connections between the intercollegiate esports and our undergraduate programming. As a department, we've actually expanded our footprint in cross-disciplinary collaborations across campus. And what this is really important is because we bring our students along with us. So whenever we're talking about research projects, everybody thinks that we're just doing these research projects on our own. We're always bringing our students along with us. So specifically, our program right now has active collaborations with the School of Health Sciences, Engineering and Mines, Business and Public Administration, Nursing and Public Disciplines, and Aerospace. Dr. Tanis Walsh currently has active grants with the Department of Education and the Department of Homeland Health and Human Services. Dr. John Fitzgerald actually serves as senior sports scientist for our hockey team, and so he's in there quite a bit. And additionally, we have faculty in our department that are receiving both NASA and U.S. Army funding. And so we've had quite a bit of success in research, bringing those students along with us and giving them some really interesting interactions. For instance, one of our students is actually going to be going to Johnson Space Center with us within the next month or so on a research grant with us. So we've had a lot of success in those ways. And so when we're looking at scholarships, like the ones that we're given today, these are going to ensure that the student population that is growing, they have one less thing to worry about. And the financial security that these help provide really is a big boost to our program. And we have to say that a lot of these successes are riding on the backs of those scholarships that are given out to our students. Thank you.
Good afternoon. Before I start on my spiel, I want to just let you know who was just speaking because they forgot to introduce themselves. Dr. Cheryl Hunter is our interim dean, filling the gap in the time that we select a new dean for our college, and she's doing a wonderful job, so let's give her a round of applause. Yeah. And Jenny Blado, Dr. Jenny Blado, is the director of teacher education, and I couldn't even begin to guess all of the things that you do, Jenny, but she does an incredible job making sure students are placed, making sure she navigates the legislation that's coming out, and so much more. But thank you so much. And then I've actually met Dr. Jesse Rhodes. This is my first time, so thank you so much for joining us today. Good afternoon. I am Ashley Stocker, Director of Development for the College of Education and Human Development. Long, obnoxious title, but really I'm a fundraiser for the college. So it's my honor to welcome you guys today, our generous donors, alumni, friends, student scholarship recipients, distinguished faculty, and guests. My role at the Alumni Foundation is to build and steward relationships with alumni and friends and connect their passions to the purpose of the college. And it's been a pleasure. I've been here for just over a year. Our focus at the Alumni Foundation continues to be one of gratitude. Without these remarkable gifts to our students, many would find themselves struggling to meet the financial needs of earning their degrees. Our alumni and students alike truly embody UND's Leaders in Action motto, and we are proud to call them a part of the UND family. At this time, can I ask that all donors and scholarship recipients stand to be recognized as we extend our gratitude for their generosity? Don't be shy, stand on up. Congratulations, everyone. Before we move on to the next part of our program, I wouldn't be doing my job as an Alumni Association and Foundation employee if I didn't invite all of you to the event we're having tomorrow. 1:30 in the large ballroom, there will be a very exciting announcement happening, and the event is called Forever Starts Here. I'm not going to give away any hints, but it will change the trajectory of UND, and you're going to want to be there. So please join us tomorrow if you can. And it will be online as well, so check out the events page on the alumni website. You guys know how when you say, like, plan your life and God just laughs, like, that's kind of what happened today. So we had certain people that were going to be on this panel with us, and then, of course, COVID strikes. And so Dr. Gail Ingleson, she's a professor emeritus. A lot of you know her. She is homesick with COVID, but she has a really incredible story and was going to be joining our panel. But I want to share her story. She has a really important message that she wants all of you to hear. She sent it to me in first person, so I'm going to read it in third person, so bear with me. Pretend I'm Gail, sort of. So she says, "What an exciting day for our students, faculty, staff, and donors. Today is about celebrating our goals, dreams, and futures. For our students, we celebrate your success as you continue to prepare your journey into a helping profession." Gail has been employed at UND since 1988 and in the College of Education and Human Development for the past 30 years. She received her undergraduate, master's, and doctoral degrees from this great college and university. Throughout her collegiate journey, she was fortunate enough to receive scholarships or tuition waivers that supported her financially as she earned her degree. And this is where the story begins. Gail remembers sitting at her undergraduate commencement ceremony and hearing a speaker talk about giving back to the university. She vaguely remembers the phrase, "to give your time, talent, and treasure." Not entirely sure what that meant, but being in the teaching profession seemed like a way to share her time and talent. Before long, she realized that it was now time to pay it forward. She thought about how wonderful it was to have a scholarship to support her academics as well as allow her to experience college to the fullest degree. After beginning her teaching career, she started to think about pay it forward. So at the age of 26, she sent her first donation to UND. It wasn't much. The check was for $50. But the moral of the story is that it started her on her philanthropic journey. And that has benefited students and programs for the past 38 years. Let's give a round of applause to Gail. She's not here, but hopefully she's watching online. Her message is this: it is okay to start small. Just start somewhere. Gail is very proud to have been in the education profession for the last 43 years. She's very proud that she received her education at the University of North Dakota within the College of Education and Human Development. And she is very proud of all of you. She says, good luck and have a great year. At this point, I would like to invite our panelists up, and then I will do a brief introduction of all of them, and then we'll answer some questions. So come on up, panelists.
Thank you.
So like I said, not the panel that is on the program. You'll see Don Santer on the program from ND80 as well, and they are a generous scholarship donor, but unfortunately he became ill as well and wasn't able to make it. We do have some representation from ND80 here today though, so thank you for coming. Wanted to introduce the panel before we get started. This is Janelle Holth. She's a 73 graduate of UND. She received her BS in nursing from UND. And along with her husband, Rod, a 74 accounting grad, they created the Jennifer Holth Winkles Memorial Scholarship Endowment in honor of their daughter, Jennifer, who had a sociology and social work degree and did home care for those with special needs. This endowment is intended to honor Jennifer's goal to help her son, Christian, who is on the autism spectrum, and provide scholarships for students who are working or plan to work with individuals on the autism spectrum. Janelle continues to give her time to UND, serving on the campaign task force for the College of Education and Human Development. Welcome, Janelle. I'm gonna jump over to Marilyn Guy. So Marilyn is a 69, 71, and 76 grad of UND. She went all the way. she received her BS in Elementary Ed, Master of Education, and Doctor of Education from UND. She is a SUE Award winner and was involved in many organizations during her time at UND. Marilyn went on to teach in the Education Department at Concordia College. Following her retirement, Concordia created an award for students in her namesake called the Marilyn Guy Award for Excellence in Leadership. Marilyn serves on several boards in her retirement and is also continuing to serve as a campaign task force member for the College of Education as well. Marilyn and her husband, Bill, have created the William and Marilyn Guy Education Scholarship Endowment, the Law Scholarship Endowment, and the Business Scholarship Endowment. Wow, thanks for being here, Marilyn. And then we have our students, our wonderful recipients. So Kira Dahl is a Bismarck Mandan native, expected to graduate in December of this year. Congratulations, Kira. Area of study is Bachelor in Elementary Ed and Middle Level Education with a specialization in English and Social Studies. And she has received Gail Engelson's scholarship. Then we have Gavin Nadeau, and he is from Belcourt, North Dakota, and graduation date of May 2024, and area of study is an EDD in Educational Practice and Leadership, and you are the recipient of the Donald and Ann Lemon Scholarship. Then we have Ellen Gregoire from Larimore, North Dakota, expected graduation date of August 25. Early childhood education with a certificate in special education and received the Vasleyville Spirit Scholarship. So welcome, all of you. Let's give them a round of applause. Sorry, I've been talking a lot. So I'm gonna start with our donors, if that's okay. And I would like Janelle, if that's okay, to go first, to tell us why you created your scholarship endowment.
It's on. Good afternoon, everybody. Where to start and how to end so that I don't stay off track here a little bit, but our endowment began with a conversation with a member from the Alumni Association. So we lost our daughter 6 years ago and 26 days ago. And at that time, we talked about what can we do to remember Jennifer, and really never came to any conclusion. In the meantime, unfortunately, Jennifer had died from an overdose of prescription drugs, accidentally. And I put my effort into what seemed to be the right thing of working with the North Dakota Board of Medicine so that their provider was disciplined, and he was. But it still left us with a huge emptiness. And our son, who sits on the board with the Alumni Association, suggested I talk to, at that time, Dan Muse was working there. And so during COVID, during 2020, we began conversations and found out the ability of how to remember Jennifer and decided to go forward with that, created an endowment, and a little unconventionally went out on social media and made the announcement, and within 6 weeks, we had the endowment funded so that it could begin accruing and giving back to students. That endowment has grown considerably, and our goal is to continue to work with that in different ways. What I found in particular is that I finally had an avenue to remember Jennifer, and it felt good. Instead of crying about everything that I reached out to try to do for her, this felt like something that could go on forever. And it was important to us to be here with you today, to meet the students, to listen to their passion for education. The endowment is targeted to a student that wishes to work with children and families through autism, through a diagnosis of autism, and help those children and the parents to help the student reach their goals to be the best they can be in life. Jennifer's son, Christian, has autism. I've been with them and I've gone to IEPs, which I know all of you would probably understand can be a challenge. I saw Jennifer dig in her heels and speak to the rights of that little boy who's now 16. On a bit of a sad note, unfortunately, Jennifer's husband died this summer from a medical issue. And so I am now the grandma that will be at every IEP. And he's in a good place today, and he has a good teacher, and all of that is a success for him. So I'm here today with my husband to thank all of you for choosing teaching and to look for those teachers again that are working with a special needs children. It's just so important that they are supported and are pushed to be the best that they can be too. This endowment has allowed us to take a deep breath and not feel pain at every breath of our waking moment. And today we celebrate Jennifer, and I thank you for celebrating with us and celebrating her memory as she cared for people with special needs and advocated for our grandson.
Thank you, Jill. Very impactful. I'm going to jump over to Marilyn, and then I'm going to check you students out. Marilyn, can you tell us why you created your scholarship endowment?
Both Bill and I feel that we've been very fortunate to have graduated from UND, and we've had wonderful life experiences. And so we wanted to give back. And my husband is a graduate of the business school and also of the law school. So you see, he got two endowments out of that deal, and I was able to have one. But we really feel that it's so important to think back on our career. We would not have done what we've done. We've not would have had the experiences in our life had we not had UND in our life. And so that's our main purpose in giving it back. We like to see people in the areas that we've been involved in have opportunities for success, and we are there to be mentors. We're there to be helpful in any way we can. And my career has been in education. My husband's career has been in law, and it's been a wonderful experience for us, and we just hope that each of you that's going into education has the kind of experience that I've had and just enjoy it. I think one of the best things about being in education is that you see these wonderful students in education and you have so much hope for the future. So thank you for going into education. You're going to make a difference in a lot of people's lives, and I just wish you the best in everything that you do. Thank you.
Thanks, Marilyn. Kind of along the lines of what Janelle and Marilyn shared, guys, and their, you know, success that they had large in part to attending UND. Can you guys share with us why you chose UND for your degree?
I guess I can just say that growing up in North Dakota, everyone hears about UND, not just hockey, but the college in general. Mm-hmm. And I do have some family members up here too, but I truly just wanted a place that I know felt right for me and was statewide too. And being in Bismarck, my life is very chaotic, And so knowing that they had a completely long-distance program for me was truly wonderful because I got to experience so many things and get to have such amazing teachers that have gone above and beyond for me in a way that is not only helpful for my education and my passion for teaching, but also just for my livelihood.
Gavin?
So I didn't know I was going to go to college out of high school. I'm from, as Ashley said, Belcourt, North Dakota. I was born and raised on the Turtle Mountain Indian Reservation. Nobody in my family has ever gone to college. My mom went for a semester and dropped out. But so I really didn't know. So I chose to come to UND because of the location, really. I followed my partner here, who just graduated with a PhD,
awesome.
Dr. Bourne. So shout her out. But I really just followed her here after attending Turtle Mountain Community College right out of high school. And we've been here since 2013, earning all of our degrees here.
Awesome. Thank you.
Yeah, so I chose to come to UND for a few different reasons. First of all, I knew that UND would provide a great education, and it had the career education path that I was looking for in the education department. Along with that, I have a lot of family in this area, so I wanted to stay close to them and my friends. And then lastly, which may be the biggest component, is I am a third generation UND student, and so I felt really called to continue the family tradition here.
Thank you. Yes, you'll find a lot of multi-generational, and then you'll also find first generation, which is exciting. Janelle, if I can ask you, what in your life, along with your daughter, instilled the desire for philanthropy or giving back?
I think as a young child growing up on a farm in North Dakota, I witnessed my parents' hard work. But more importantly, I witnessed my father always having the sense of community and making sure that as he grew in his business, he still supported in his community. Even if it wasn't the best place to enhance his operation, he knew that he needed to support those people as well. As well as the church and school in our community. So coming to UND as a student, he was also giving back to our state. I graduated in nursing and have always worked in this state. So I think the giving back that I learned at an early age was from my father and how we go forward and support our community for the betterment of individuals, businesses, and for the health and wellness of everybody.
I love that. And you'll find a lot of people who do give back. Their parents were setting really good examples at a young age. So we love to hear that. Marilyn, do you have anything to add to that?
Surely. I think parents do make a difference in our lives and what they do and how they express themselves. And that was true for my family as well. I think that the other thing that has happened in my career is I've seen the need that people have. I've taught at Concordia, as Ashley mentioned, and I see the number of first-generation students coming to Concordia or to UND, and I always have had a real special place in my heart for those students. And sometimes the need is not just financial, but in terms of understanding what a college or a university is all about. How do you operate in this kind of environment? So that has been a real pleasure to me. When I was in college, I was a member of the Delta Gamma sorority, and our project was the School for the Blind. And I did some volunteer work there, and again, recognized some students that had disabilities, and that too then influenced what I did with my career, and did study special education. And so that was another way that that opened my mind. Another area is that I've done a lot of things in terms of the Fargo community, and served on different boards, and you see different things and different kinds of needs, whether it's a healthcare board or it's a community board like the Fargo Dome or FM Area Foundation, and it's just really wonderful to see the generosity that exists and the ways in which you can connect people's passion with the needs that are out there. So I've had a wonderful career in doing that, and I just hope that I have many more years to continue doing it. Thank you.
Thanks, Marilyn. Gavin, I want to ask you, What does your receiving your scholarship mean to your journey here at UND? How does it impact at that time?
Well, number one, I think it allows me to continue my education at UND. Without scholarships and different waivers and stuff, I wouldn't 100% wouldn't have been able to earn my bachelor's degree, let alone my master's and soon to be doctoral. So it does mean a lot, and I know a lot of first generation students, they have no idea what to expect, what the real financial obligation is for college. So oftentimes they get flustered and drop out or whatever. And it was very hard to not do that right away coming in during my undergrad. It just means the world.
The scholarships have been an integral part of your journey, it sounds like. Marilyn, what advice would you give to students who will soon be entering their profession?
Be very hopeful. Always look for students and the people that you work with trust. I always say that students and everyone I work with, I'm going to trust them from the beginning until they show me any different. And once they show me something different, then it takes a long time to develop that trust. But approach people with trust. Know that they're going to have different ideas. Be welcoming to those ideas. I found in my career that sometimes a person that I disagreed with the most was the one that brought the best idea to me and ways in which we could share. So think about everyone's opportunity to contribute. Also think about your own values and your own ethics. And sometimes there are situations where you have to say, no, I can't do that. And be true to yourself. That's very important. You all bring family values, you bring cultural values to the situation that you're in, you bring experiences that you've had, and be true to yourself, because at the end of the day, that's going to be very, very important. Thank you.
Thank you. Ellen, would you share with us what other opportunities you've been able to enjoy because of your scholarship outside of your regular class schedule?
Yes, of course. So because I've been awarded this scholarship so generously, I've been able to make so many amazing connections within my community and then also the UND community, whether that's getting involved with organizations or clubs here on campus, or just spending time getting to know my classmates or professors. It's that weight that's lifted off by receiving the scholarship lets me focus on things that I know will further my education and just my character in general instead of worrying about the financial stresses.
Thank you. So true, I think. Janelle, what does it mean to you to be able to meet your scholarship recipients? I know yours maybe is not here today, but you have in the past. What is that like for you?
It's exciting to meet the student again in their career and their hopes and aspirations. And I know last year too, we got to talk about exactly what their work situation was looking like, where they were still helping out and getting more education. But that student in that meeting, it's an opportunity for me to also encourage them. To extend themselves, not overextend, like Marilyn just talked about. You know is one of the first words I think we learn how to say sometimes, and then we kind of back off as we get older. But it's important to extend ourselves in our communities, in our work environment, and take opportunities to learn more, increase our knowledge. And while you're doing that, you can mentor those other new students that are coming into your area as well. It's so many opportunities for growth, but again, the connectivity in that community, whether it's at work or where you live, and giving back that way too.
Thank you. And on the flip side of that, Kira, what is it like to meet the person who is the benefactor of your scholarship?
It's honestly truly amazing. I know I have Gail's scholarship, but I was lucky enough to at least meet her last year. So we had a nice long chat last year, which was wonderful. She's truly a remarkable human being. She's the kindest person, kindest soul ever. And I'm truly honored that I get to represent her scholarship because I did not think when I came to UND, I was planning on going into elementary education. I did not think I would go back to middle school ever. And I found out that it is the age group that is my passion and love. Their kids are just so wonderful. And meeting Gail and talking to her more about it, I've just realized how many experiences I get to live through with her through the scholarship. And it's just, it's truly been amazing at UND, and it's been amazing getting to meet her.
Thank you. I have this question under donor question, but I actually think it's a really good question for all of you. So whoever wants to jump in and answer it, what are you most excited about for the future of UND and its students? Does anyone have a thought on that? I know I'm putting you guys on the spot because it wasn't on your list, but I think it's a really important question. Anyone have any thoughts? Marilyn?
Sure, I'll start. I think the work that you're doing in terms of recruiting and maintaining teachers is just an outstanding activity for UND. UND, I think, has the best teacher education program in North Dakota, all the way from bachelor's to doctoral programs, and provides so many people for other colleges and universities within the state, as well as the K-12 system. And we really, really need good teachers. And anything that we can do, I know the governor is now having a task force and contributing and working with that, I think is going to be very important. But any way that we can recruit people to come into the field of education, help them to be successful, help them to see that they're valued, is going to be so important. So I'm supporting you. Thank you.
So I think the thing that I am most excited about for UND is how the teacher education program continually evolves with the changing when we determine upcoming best practices. The program is always evolving to teach us those practices, so we're always on top of it as soon as we enter our career.
That's a great point. A classroom does not look like it did 20 years ago.
Yep. I'll take a shot. So coming from a student affairs perspective, outside of classroom experiences were instrumental in my success at UND, and I think President Armacost and his administration are really full force in supporting that ideology. So I'm excited for that to be more of a thing, more of a formal thing. Mm-hmm. So there's some things in the works right now. Ooh. So it's, we'll see.
Exciting. Do you have anything to add, Kira?
Sure. So I guess I just love that the program itself is constantly evolving, not just for us, but also with our students. So we always get to see all the kids that we get to work with. Not only do we get to see their classrooms and how they evolve, but the college is constantly changing to meet those endeavors that we know that we need, so that way we can better help our students and give them the education that they deserve, and that essentially, since we are students ourselves, we also get to deserve.
Nice. Janelle, anything?
Yeah. I think just to note, my husband and I have attended events at the Alumni Center quite a bit, and hearing some of the movement here on the university and direction that we're going only speaks to the quality of the programming that's being added, the doors that are opening up for our students and for our community, only make us better and more rounded, but to enhance the programming that's already existing, again, everything getting better and just more opportunities. So this is a very progressive university. We're all very proud of the university and being here and being able to see the things going on at UND.
I would have to agree with that, Gavin and Janelle. I think our leadership on campus right now is second to none, and that it starts with Andy at the top, and you're feeling that, and you're feeling the momentum on campus and really exciting things happening. So all good things coming, hopefully. I don't know how I'm doing on time, but I'm going to maybe just wrap with opening it up to, is there anything else that any of you would like to share or thank your donor, or the floor is yours for the next 3 to 5 minutes, I guess, if you have anything else you want to share?
I would just like to add to all the students out there to stay connected to your university. As my husband and I walked in today, we said, why didn't we have some of this when we were here? We had great things here, but the opportunities for you to gather, to be connected with each other, to meet new people, to study well, to learn well, has just been so enhanced, and there's been so much growth, and there's so much beauty in it, just to be present here today. I worked at our health system for many years, and as they build the new hospital, some of the same thought and language is going on there to make that space there welcoming to everybody, because it is another part of your home. So take these opportunities while you're here. Enjoy every minute of it. Yes, work hard, but they go hand in hand. You need that balance in life, and always extend yourself back to the university and stay connected.
Great advice. Anyone else have anything they want to add?
I just want to say, to remember it as becoming a teacher, you're going to have an influence on so many people. And I remember one of the people that had an influence on me here was a woman in education, a teacher education professor, and her name was Clara Peterson. And you remember, I graduated in 1969, so things were different. And she just dressed beautifully. And every day she came into class, and she had a beautiful suit on, high heels, and her hair looked just lovely, and she just looked wonderful. So the first year that, after I had graduated, my husband and I were living in San Diego, and Clara Peterson called. And she said, Marilyn, I'm coming out to the reading conference in Anaheim, which isn't too far from San Diego, and I wondered if I could come and stay with you for a couple of nights. Mm-hmm. I was just flabbergasted. My husband and I lived in a one-bedroom apartment, and we, of course, gave her the bed, and we slept on the floor in the living room. And my husband was in the Navy at that time, and so we were trying to think of what could we do with her. You know, we were just kind of overwhelmed. And so we decided to take her on board his ship for dinner. And I don't know how many of you have ever been on a Navy ship, but if you go from floor to floor on a Navy ship, you're walking up a ladder. And here came Clara with her high heels, her tight skirt on her suit that she was wearing, and up and down she went on this ship, and loved it, and was just as graceful as she could possibly be. I'll never forget that, and I always will remember how important it is to reach out to your students, how important it is to take advantage of whatever they're doing and to make the best of it. So think about those kinds of things. I remember her. That's why I think so wonderfully about UND, and I hope you will think about that too. And later I'm going to tell a story to Eric about Don Lemon, who I happened to teach with when I was here as a teaching assistant, but I can't tell the story in a large group. Thank you.
Awesome. Anything students want to add?
I guess I would just like to personally say thank you to not only my scholarship donors, but all of the scholarship donors who are here today. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Yeah, very true. Janelle and Marilyn, you both said the word connected, and Andy Armacost, if you've ever heard him speak in the last few months, he's declared this year the year of connectivity and connectedness, and so I think it really just goes right along with everything we're talking about today. And so I want to thank you all for joining us up on stage, and then I'm going to turn it over to Jared Schlenker for our closing remarks and have you guys go ahead and take your seats again. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Jared Schlenker. I am the Interim Associate Dean of Student Services in the college, and just like to thank everyone for coming today. I spent most of my career in PK-12 as a high school English teacher, followed by a secondary principal. And I'm often asked, you know, what is, you know, one thing you really enjoy about your current position here at UND? And my genuine answer that was pretty much the same thing as it was when I was a high school principal and teacher was that I love to see students reach their goals and achieve their dreams. And I heard that quite frequently today throughout with many of our speakers and students. And I was actually, probably about 15 years ago, out in these seats as well as a student. And I had received two scholarships during my time here at UND, and just really appreciative. I remember those feelings of appreciation for the donors and the university for allowing me, a small town farm kid from North Dakota, to achieve my dreams. So I'd like to thank you for that. So one more round of applause to our scholarship donors. I have a list for the last few items from Leslie Risky, and I don't want to forget or don't want to not mention her name here as well. She is in the back, our event coordinator. There was a lot of support staff that helped her out, but Leslie Risky, thank you so much for putting this together and helping us. So first of all, we'd like to say the scholarship recipients, please be sure to have your photo taken before you leave in room 233 across the hall. So any scholarship recipients, you would want to get your picture taken. Number two, everyone, please drop off your name badge holder in the registration table. So if you have one of these name badge holders, if you could drop those back off on the registration table on your way out. Also, I see a handful of boxed lunches that are still back there. So they don't want to see any of those left when the event is cleared out. So go ahead and take another lunchbox if there's anything back there. So one more round of applause for everyone involved. And you are free to leave. Thank you.